Good morning, students. In today's revision, we will talk about the types of landforms. Which are they? Types of landforms. They are first mountains, valley, plateaus, plains. Now, first we will just discuss about the mountains. What are mountains? And high elevated land which have steep sides and a conical at the top. A very high elevated land, then from the surrounding area, from the surrounded area, what the land is around it. It is an high elevated land with steep sides and a conical at the top. This is called as mountain. Mountains are of different types. First, fold mountain, block mountains, and third one is volcanic. Now, instead of explaining in detail, as I had already explained to you when I was just taking the class, so here we are doing the revision. Will tell you only the important points. What are fold mountains? Fold mountains are the result of wrinkles on the. These are the wrinkles on the earth surface or on the rock strata. When there are wrinkles on the rock strata, these mountains are formed due to the result of extra compression from the opposite sides. When compression is there, from the opposite sides, the rock strata just, okay, there is a wrinkle in the upper surface, and this is the compression. It forms like this. The up folds are called as anticline. Just remember, the up folds are called as anticlines, whereas the down folds are called as synclines. What have to keep it in mind? Fold mountains, when they are formed, there are wrinkles on the surface of the earth or on the rock strata, and it just take a shape like this. The upfolds are called as anticline, the downfolds are called as syncline. That is enough to know about the fold mountains. Now, fold mountains are of two types: young fold mountains and old fold mountains. So also come to know, there are two types of fold mountains: old fold mountains and young fold mountains. They are formed 250 million years ago, and they are formed 25 million years ago. Just remember some of the examples in the world related with Young Fold Mountain and the Old Fold Mountain. Next is the Block Mountains. Block mountains are the result of faulting on the rock strata. Faulting, faults are there. Where as what I told tell about it, that fold mountains are because of the faults or the wrinkles, and this is because of the faults. What happened here, the rock strata just is there like this, and due to the tension, here the tension is there, and because of that the rock strata get cracked and lowers it level over a period of time. This is the formation of block mountain, and the remaining part shaped like this, the it get depressed. This forms the rift valley. This form the rift valley. Now we will discuss as in your book only the example of rift valley is described. Rest no other valley is explained here in the chapter. So because of the faults on the rock strata, there is a formation of block mountains. It is in the shape of block, therefore it is called as block mountain. This is called as horst, and this is called as graben, graben. And the formation of rock strata like this is called as a rift valley. Now just remember some of the examples also. This is enough about the to know about the block mountain. Come to the volcanic mountains. These are due to the volcanic eruption, the eruption of lava on the surface of the earth. This is called as vent. When due to the volcanic eruption, the lava, magma, molten rocks, etc., all together, heat, gases, all come out together on the surface of the earth and forms the shape of the mountain. It is called as volcanic mountain. And just some of the examples are the Mount Fujiyama, Mount Kilimanjaro, Mount Vesuvius of Italy, Fujiyama of Japan, and Mount Kilimanjaro of Africa are some of the examples of volcanic mountain. Whereas for the Black Forest is an example of the block mountains. Black Forest in Germany and Vosges in France, Vindhyas in the India are some of the example of block mountains. Next is valleys. What are valleys? A lowlands between the two mountains or the hills is called as valley. So whatever definition you get in the same consent as the lowlands between two hills or the mountain is called as valley. You can get the definition and you have to find out which landform it is describing. So make your concept clear about the terms. What is mountain, what is valley, what is plains, what is plateaus, and their different types. This much is given. In next class, we'll talk about the plateaus and plains. Nothing to be worried. Just make your concept clear. Read the chapters. Read both the chapters very well. That is enough. And keep it in mind the concept. Have a good day. Thank you.